Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Weekly News at a Glance, a show where you get a comprehensive coverage of weekly current affairs. So before I start today's video, there is an announcement I want to make. As we all know, August 22nd the JRPT LDC exam ache. For that, amra ek duto mock test prepare korechi on paper 2. And those papers we will upload on our Telegram channel. Ei weekend moddhe kore debo. So if you want to attempt those mocks, you can join our Telegram channel. The link will be given in the description below. Also, JRPT shop information plus kichu important topics একটা ভিডিও বানানো হয়েছে যে কী কী তোমরা পড়তে পারো, যে কী কোন কোন টপিকগুলি ইম্পর্টেন্ট আছে লাস্ট ডেজে যেগুলি তোমাদের রিভাইজ করা উচিত, সেটা একটা ভিডিও আমাদের চ্যানেলে অলরেডি আছে, সেটা লিঙ্ক আমি ডিসক্রিপশনে দিয়ে দেবো। ইফ ইউ ওয়ান্ট ইউ ক্যান চেক দ্যাট আউট। অ্যান্ড থার্ড, জিআরপিটি এক্সপিরিয়েন্সদের জন্য স্পেশালি চ্যানেলে রেগুলারলি কারেন্ট অ্যাফেয়ার্স, সিক্স মান্থস ওল্ড কারেন্ট অ্যাফেয়ার্স প্লাস জেনারেল নলেজের উপর প্লাস ইংলিশ ভোক্যাবসের উপরও রোজ এমসিকিউস নেওয়া হয় 20-25টা করে। If you want, you can attempt those quiz too. So that's all. Video or Telegram channel link niche description dao ache, tumra okhan theke dekhe ni. So now let's start our weekly current affairs. A Tamil inscription that was laid in the ring of Kakati Emperor Pratapa Rudra Dev was found at the Motupalli village Chirala in Prakasham district. The Tamil language inscription carved in the Tamil Granth script is dated to 1308 AD. The inscription is registering the gift of land as Tirudayavattam for providing offerings to the god. Swarnim Vijay Varsh victory flame at Khardungla Pass, the world's highest motorable road, was welcomed with a solemn ceremony of reception by army personnel, veterans, local residents and tourists. The army paid tributes to the brave hearts of 1971 war as part of the ongoing Swarnim Vijay Varsh celebrations to commemorate 50 years of India's victory in the 1971 Indo-Pak War. In a significant boost to connectivity between India and Bangladesh, a goods train loaded with stone chips arrived at Chilahati in Bangladesh from India to the Haldibari-Chilahati route. The train was dispatched from the Damdim station of the Northeast Frontier Railway. This rail route has been revived 56 years after being discontinued during the Indo-Pak War of 1965. Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched e-Rupee, a cashless and contactless instrument for digital payment. e-Rupee is a person and purpose-specific digital payment solution. It is a QR code or SMS string-based e-voucher which is delivered to the mobile of the beneficiaries. e-Rupee has been developed by National Payments Corporation of India on its UPI platform in collaboration with Department of Financial Services and NHA. India took over the presidency of the United Nations Security Council for the month of August. The External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar said, India's vision has been steered by dialogue and cooperation, mutual respect and commitment to international law. Maritime security, peacekeeping and counter-terrorism will be the focus areas for India during its presidency. A hotline was established between Indian Army at Kongrala in North Sikkim and the People's Liberation Army of China at Kambadzong in Tibetan Autonomous Region to further the spirit of trust and cordial relations along the borders. The event coincided with the PLA Day on 1st August 2021. Under India's At Risk policy and to enhance military cooperation with friendly countries, a task force of Indian Navy Eastern Fleet is to proceed on an overseas deployment to Southeast Asia, South China Sea and Western Pacific. The Indian Naval Task Group includes guided missile destroyer Ranvijay, guided missile frigate Shivalik, anti-submarine corvette Kadmat, and guided missile corvette Kora. Bhubaneswar, capital of Odisha, has become the first city in India to achieve 100% vaccination of its people against COVID-19. Additionally, about 1 lakh migrant workers have also been administered the first dose of COVID vaccine in the capital city. Glenmark Pharmaceuticals and Sanofi Research and Development Corp announced an exclusive long-term strategic partnership to manufacture, market and distribute its breakthrough nitric oxide nasal spray in Asian markets including India, Singapore, Malaysia, Sri Lanka, etc. To safeguard the interest of its customers, the State Bank of India has launched a new security feature, SIM binding in YONO and YONO Lite. The new version of the platforms will protect customers from various digital frauds. With the SIM binding feature, YONO and YONO Lite will work only on devices which have SIM or mobile numbers registered with the bank. World's largest star sapphire cluster has been found in Ratnapura, Sri Lanka. The stone is pale blue in color and was found by laborers while digging a well in a gem trader's home. Ratnapura is known as the gem capital of the country. Indian naval ship Khanjar becomes the first Indian Navy ship to call at the heritage coastal port of Gopalpur in Odisha. The two-day visit was organized as part of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav as well as Swarnim Vijay Varsh celebrations to commemorate the 75th anniversary of independence and 50th anniversary of the 1971 war. Niti Aayog released a report which presents reform pathways to transform the country's power distribution sector. The report titled Turning Around the Power Distribution Sector is co-authored by Niti Aayog, RMI and RMI India. The report presents a review of reform efforts in the Indian and global power distribution sector. India has joined the community of Portuguese language countries as associate observer. This sets a new platform for strengthening India's historic bonds of friendship with Lusophone countries and pursuing cooperation in areas of mutual interest. This will enrich and strengthen India's ties with Portugal. In a major boost to exports of exotic fruit, consignments of fiber and mineral-rich dragon fruit, which are sourced from farmers of Gujarat and West Bengal, have been exported for the first time to London and Bahrain. The consignment of exotic fruit exported to London was sourced from farmers of Kutch, Gujarat, while the consignment exported to Bahrain was from West Bengal. Indigenous aircraft carrier Vikrant, designed by Indian Navy's Directorate of Naval Design, is being built at Cochin Shipyard Limited. IAC is a leading example of the nation's quest for Atmanirbhar Bharat with more than 76% indigenous constant. This is the maiden attempt of the Indian Navy and Cochin Shipyard to indigenously design and build an aircraft carrier. The ISA Vikrant set sail for its first sea trial on 4th August. It will be commissioned on August 2022. The West Bengal government has received 4 Scotch awards for its schemes under the Ease of Doing Business initiative. The state scheme Shilpa Sathi, the online single window portal, won the Platinum Award, while the auto renewal of Certificate of Enlistment through online system for urban areas has received the Gold Award. Online issuance of trade licenses and the e-Nathikaran own 2 silver. IndusInd Bank has been empaneled by the RBI to act as an agency bank to facilitate transactions related to government business. The first direct flight operations between Imphal and Shillong was flagged off under the Regional Connectivity Scheme Ure Desh Ka Aam Nagarik, that is Uran. This route fulfills the center's objective to establish strong aerial connectivity in priority areas of Northeast India. The Cabinet approved the School Education Program Samagra Shiksha Scheme 2.0. The scheme runs from April 1, 2021 to March 31, 2026. It has been given a financial outlay of Rs. 2.94 lakh crore for this period. The scheme covers 1.16 million schools, over 156 million students and 5.7 million teachers of government and aided schools from pre-primary to senior secondary level. ICICI Prudential Life Insurance has tied up with the National Payments Corporation of India to provide Unified Payments Interface AutoPay facility to its customers. SBI General Insurance, one of India's leading general insurance companies, announced a tie-up with Manipal Business Solutions to increase insurance penetration in the rural markets. SahiPay, the fastest-growing tech-enabled financial inclusion platform of Manipal Business Solutions, provides digital and financial services to customers in semi-urban and rural India. Suryoday Small Finance Bank launched the Suryoday Health and Wellness Savings Account, a premium savings account product aimed at ensuring that the customer's wealth not only grows, but they and their families are also taken care of on their health. Uttarakhand becomes the first state to launch an earthquake alert app named Uttarakhand Bhukamp Alert. Uttarakhand Chief Minister Pushkar Singh Dhami launched the app, available for download on both Android and iOS platforms. The app was developed by the Uttarakhand State Disaster Management Authority and the Indian Institute of Technology, Roorkee. Pani Ma, or Water Month, has been launched in Ladakh to inform villagers about the importance of clean water. The Ladakh government has announced a reward of Rs. 2.5 million for the first block in each district that achieves the status of Har Ghar Jal. The campaign will adopt a three-pronged approach focusing on water quality testing, planning and strategizing water supply. Myanmar formed a Republic of the Union of Myanmar Caretaker Government according to an order by the State Administration Council. Under the order, the new caretaker government will be led by the Commander-in-Chief of Defence Services. In collaboration with the Ministry of External Affairs, TRIFED is to set up an Atmanirbhar Bharat corner in 100 Indian missions or embassies across the world. The corner will be an exclusive place to promote GI Tech tribal art and craft products. The countries which rewarded are Jamaica, Ireland, Turkey, Kenya, Mongolia, Israel, Finland, France and Canada. The 720 megawatt Mangdechu hydroelectric project, an India-Bhutan venture, has been awarded the prestigious Brunel Medal for Excellence in Civil Engineering by the UK-based Institute of Civil Engineers. To make Tata cars more affordable, Tata Motors has partnered with Sundaram Finance to offer 100% financing options to its customers. The financing option is available across Tata's passenger segment offering in India. Indian Bank entered into an MOU with NSRCEL, an incubation arm of the Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore, for extending exclusive credit to startups. The initiative was part of the bank's InSpringboard scheme tailored to finance startups. Small Industries Development Bank of India, that is SIDBI, in partnership with Foreign Commonwealth and Development Office UK, has launched Swavalamban Challenge Fund to lend a helping hand to the entrepreneurs. Monetary Policy Committee of RBI has kept various rates unchanged. The repo rate is kept unchanged at 4% for the 7th consecutive time. Reverse repo, bank rate, MSF, CRR, SLR has also been kept unchanged. PM Narendra Modi announced the renaming of the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award, the country's highest sporting honour, after hockey wizard Major Dhyanchand. It will now be called Major Dhyanchand Khel Ratna Award. Renowned economist Jagdish Bhagwati and C. Rangarajan have been conferred with the inaugural Professor C.R. Rao Centenary Gold Medal. Sri Bhagwati is Professor of Economics, Law and International Relations at Columbia University, while Sri C. Rangarajan is the former Chairman of the Economic Advisory Council of PM and the former Governor of the RBI. Director General of Indian Coast Guard K. Natarajan was elected as the next Executive Director of the Regional Cooperation Agreement on Combating Piracy and Armed Robbery Against Ships in Asia. Vice Admiral S.N. Gormade assumed charge as the Vice Chief of Naval Staff at a formal ceremony held at South Block in New Delhi. He took over from Vice Admiral G. Ashok Kumar, who retired after a service of 39 years. Mini AP took charge as Managing Director of Life Insurance Corporation of India. India has appointed senior diplomat Akhilesh Mishra as the country's High Commissioner to Ireland. Governor Bhagat Singh Koshyari approved the appointment of retired Bombay High Court Judge Justice V.M. Kanare as the new Lokayukt of Maharashtra on the advice of the CM Uddhav Thackeray. Nari Shakti Purushkar awardee, centenarian sprinter Maan Kaur passes away. The 105-year-old athlete had taken up sprinting at the age of 93 and was able to win over 17 gold medals in her career. Eminent Dogri poet Padma Sachdev passes away. August 7 is observed as National Handloom Day to commemorate the Swadeshi movement and to celebrate our country's rich fabrics and colorful weaves. In Tokyo Olympics 2020, India has bagged a total number of 7 medals, 1 gold, 2 silver and 4 bronze, and ranked 47th as of the second last day of the event. This is India's best ever medal tally at any Olympics. Mirabai Chanu of India clinched a silver medal in Tokyo Olympics 2020 in weightlifting. She got India her first medal at Tokyo Olympics 2020. Indian wrestler Ravi Kumar Dahiya clinched an Olympic silver medal in 57 kg category. Shuttler PV Sindhu has won bronze medal in women's badminton singles. She has become the second Indian athlete to win 2 Olympic medals in individual events following Sushil Kumar. She is also the first Indian woman to win consecutive Olympic medals. Indian men's hockey team defeated Germany to win the bronze medal at the Tokyo Olympics 2021. This is India's first Olympics medal in hockey since they won the gold medal in the 1980 Olympics in Moscow. In Tokyo Olympics, boxer Lovlina Borgohain from Assam has bagged a bronze medal in welterweight 69 kg category. Indian wrestler Bajrang Punia clinched an Olympic bronze medal in 65 kg freestyle category. Neeraj Chopra, the first Indian to win a gold in athletics for India at an Olympic event, has also become the second Indian to win an individual gold in the Olympics. He clinched the gold medal in javelin with a jumbo throw of 87.58 meter. So that's all for this week. I sincerely hope that this session has helped you a lot. So see you in the next week. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.